Ah, nothing like a nice coffee in the afternoon with a friend. Thank you for meeting me here, mon ami. Truly, you have made the day all that much more beautiful just by gracing me with your presence. But we are not here to simply exchange pleasantries back and forth, though it would be no trouble to spend the rest of the evening complimenting you. Even so, I have heard that you are in need of advice, oui? And who better to guide you in the ways of love and passion than myself? You've come to the right place. I've always loved this cafe. The espresso, in combination with the view of the Zin, is très bon. Do you not also find it enchanting? Ah, you're right. I did not notice the clouds. They resemble a little bird, a dove, perhaps. You can see her wings spread out in the blue of the sky. That is a good sign indeed. A dove represents peace and purity and an everlasting love. Ah, c'est une bonne chose. I know the future will be kind to you, mon ami. Love is in the air. I can feel it. And so, we must discuss. It is hard to know exactly where to begin when giving advice, especially on love and romance, both things with which I have a vast and thorough knowledge about. The first thing I must insist, always, is that you follow your heart, even when it seems impossible. Your heart is the center of your soul, and you must learn to love yourself before you can accept love from anyone else. A soul without love is about as useless as a body without a brain. So do not listen to those who tell you to do away with emotions, or do not pursue childish things that make you happy. C'est n'importe quoi. Your happiness is your greatest strength. Your love is your most precious gift. No one else can tell you how to use it. Even so, there are times when someone can love too much, so much that it breaks them in half. I have known many a broken heart, and it is indeed like dying over and over. A broken heart can ruin even the happiest person. But it is my wish to mend all of these broken hearts and help bring every lover back to life. It is not always possible, Moko. But I know it is possible for those who have learned how to love themselves above all else. So you must remember to embrace your emotions and your desires, no matter what others say. Loving yourself is the most important thing. Ah, and that brings me to my next point. Never pursue someone who does not wish for you to love yourself. There is always pressure to change in order to appeal to someone who appeals to you, but it is never worth it, I promise. You know who you are, and who you are can change with the flow of the river. This is true. But you must evolve in your own way, not because someone else requires it of you. What happens if you become someone new overnight and your lover has moved on? You have lost yourself for someone who does not wish to come and find you. That is not love, mon coeur. Love changes people together. So, when you go out with your next date, don't try and guess about what they want or what they like. If there is love between you, it will find its own way. You have to be yourself, even if it seems as though that is not what others want. There is always someone who will want it. Don't get caught up in looking too hard. Love will find you, and like most magical things, it will find you when you are least expecting it. So do not worry if you are still waiting. The longer you wait, the stronger your love will grow, so that when you do find it, it will be unbreakable. You may not believe me, but you should, because I have seen it again and again, 100 times, a million. Love always finds a way. It is a power that even I can never fully understand. Everyone has the capacity to love and be loved. So don't waste your time trying to impress people who don't understand the difference between self-love and narcissism. Those people will fall in and out of love forever, until they learn the truth. But you and I, mon ami, we are much wiser than they are. Not everyone can say they have friends to guide them in the ways of true love. No, you are well on your way to happiness, I can tell. Provided, of course, that it is everlasting and not simply temporary bliss. And that reminds me, I've heard a rumor that you've had the misfortune to... Well, I won't put it that way. But I must advise, be careful of who you choose to spend your time with, especially if there is too much beer involved. I don't wish to name names, but some countries in particular can be quite a handful when they are drunk. I would not wish for someone as refined and tasteful as yourself to fall victim to any unfortunate circumstances involving, let's say, an English person who doesn't understand his own tolerance for drink.
Quoi? What do I mean?
Well, never mind, mon ami. I am simply looking out for you as a friend. That is, if that is what you wish for us to remain. Time will tell, will it not? For now, what makes me happy is your presence in my life. It would be quite a lonely existence without you. And seeing you falling in love, even if it is not with me, well, it makes me happy all the same. With you around, I feel as though there is nothing much more that I can say. Having you here is peace enough. And besides, entre deux carcassins, nous buissons des paroles. Let us enjoy the view together, oui. The pleasure, as always, is mine, mon cher.